No, I'm going to grade the 6th and 7th parts of the plumber block. This is called as a load nut and this is called as a log nut. Here he has mentioned 6th is a nut, M10 nut, and this is a log nut, and this can able to pair the loads because that is it is called as a load nut. So in order to first I'll create this, then onwards I'll create the 7th part. So I'll go to the mechanical design, under mechanical design go to the part design, select the plane. I'm going to select this plane. I'll go to the sketch. Next I'll go to the hexagon, select the center as the center of the plane itself. I'll do the dimensioning of this. This is 10 mm. Next I'll exit from the workbench. Now I'll go to the pad command. So I'll use a mirror extend. So total is how much? 8 mm. So I'll take it as a 4 mm because from the mid plane it will be 4 mm on both the sides. So total will be, total height will be 8 mm. Next, I'll zoom this. I'll select this plane. I need to produce the internal threads. So, the internal threads is in the motor M10 threads. I'll go to the hole. Next I'll go to the thread definition, select the threaded option. Next I'll go for the thick pitch. This is M10 here. Select M10. Next it is, the thread depth is 8 mm. And this is also, hole depth is also 8 mm because from here to here it is 8 mm. This is not exactly at the center. What I do, I'll go to the extension here, I'll select the word, I'll click on the positioning sketch. So this is our hole here. What I do, I want to locate exactly at the center of this, center of the hexagon. So I'll select this and I'll select this also, this plane. I'll go for the constraint, that is coincide. Next again I'll select this hole and this plane. Again I'll give the constraint, that is a coincide. So now it is exactly at the center of the this hexagon. Now I'll exit from the workbench. See here, the whole diameter it is automatically taking, the software itself it is taking automatically. They know to enter the value of the whole dia here. The what whole dia is 8.376, the what 8.376 here also. Preview. So this is a final view of the 6th part, that is a load nut. Sometimes these sharp corners, okay, while assembling may hurt the person who is doing the assembly. So because that reason, some people try to remove the these sharp corners. So you can you can remove, or otherwise you can use the this whole nut as itself. Okay, so I want to remove these sharp corners now. How to remove this one, I'll tell you. Select the plane, go for the sketch. Next, I'll go to the project 3D elements, select this edge, next this, next I'll go for the 3-point arc, sorry, I'll exit from this, press escape button on the keyboard. I'll go to the corner command, I'll select this line and this line. So I'll give around 3 mm, or you can give around 2 mm also, that is left to you. I'll give around 3 mm radius. Next, I'll use trim command here. I'll extend this line till this, and this line select once again the trim option till here. Next, I'll remove the unwanted portion by using the quick trim option. Remove this and remove this. I'll select the word this sketch, I'll mirror this about this. Next, I'll exit from the workbench, go for the group command, select the axis of this nut, enter 360 degree, preview this. This is our low nut. So we have removed the what? These sharp corners. Or otherwise you enter the corner radius as a 2 mm. So it is turning into red color. So because I need to update this, so click on the update command here. So this is our load nut here. Now I'm going to save this as a load nut M10. Now how to create this log nut, I'll tell you here itself. In this file itself, what you do, you change the word fat, click double click on this fat option, or otherwise you click the right click the mouse button and edit the fat. So what I do, this is here, total is 5 mm. From the midplane it will be how much? 2.5. Now what I do, I'll update this. So this is our lock nut name. This is a lock nut. A little bit I'll change the corner radius by double clicking on the this sketch. I'll give the corner radius around 1 mm. Or otherwise you can keep the 2 mm itself, that is left to you. So I'll exit from the workbench, I'll update the word this corner radius. So this is the lock nut. So I've removed all these sharp corners. So I'm going to save this as a lock nut.